Well, here I am. How are you? I'm here with Eric.
Hi.
Hey-o. Hey-o. recently had a birthday, Eric. Same with Chris. But that's not important. Well, we did shoot this week's show, and it was with Eddie Pepitone and Joey Zare on drums, Lynn Shore on keyboards and horns and synthesizer, and it was a fun show. Now, because it was the first one they shot, we didn't live stream it. We're going to look at it and probably make a tweak here and there. And I would say only because it's the first one. Obviously, after this, they'll come out with the episodes. But it was the first one. They want to see how it looked. But I would say under 2 weeks, you'll be able to view it. So there's that. But it was Eddie Pepitone, man. Whew. Jingle Joe, thanks for some fun stuff. Blue Collar Distro. Did I say that right, Eric?
Yeah.
We have all the shirts up. They were out for a while, but they're back up. There's that. Oh, there's a point in the show where I say screaming at somebody is never wrong. I meant never right. Now when we hit that point, you'll be like, oh, okay. I remember what he was talking about. I'm going to give a little shout out here. And this was inspired. Eric actually told me I should give these people a shout out. So we always order to George Carlin. This is true. I order from Momo Sushi all the time. It's called Momo Sushi. Tonight, when they delivered it, one of the orders was wrong. 2 hours later, they call back. Hey, we just realized when we were packing everything up, we might have given you one of the wrong items. I was like, oh, that's okay. They're like, no, we put it in the computer. The next time you call, it'll be on us. I'm like, when does that ever happen? Well, Eric said it. He goes, when does that ever happen? I'm like, never. So, I don't know, maybe you should get some stuff from Momo Sushi. Momo Sushi, how can I help you? So there's that. This was a fun show. I just want you to know that it was such a great show to shoot, because when this episode goes up and I know, like, a lot of times we do a lot of visual stuff and it's just theater of the mind, and that's great. But there's some stuff you'll really enjoy seeing. But just know when we're silly dancing at the end, I mean, we are all over the studio, silly dancing. The audience that was there to watch the show, which just means 4 people, and Steve Fine Arts and Watt and Mikey LaRue, Chris Bird and Todd Glass. Everybody was dancing all over the place. It was a lot of fun. So I think that's it. That's the show. I mean, here comes the show. I think I included everything. It was a fun show. Next week,
John Roberts.
There you go, John Roberts. I know I'm looking forward to that. And I know Chris Burden is, well, I think we're both equally looking forward to it. Could you say we're going to be a little giddy? You could. All right, everybody. Ay, ay, ay. Yay, ay, ay. You good? Okay. Didn't need me to remind you to do anything? Stop. Slow down. I love you. Goodbye.
Okay. Wait, how do you guys start the show? I don't remember how this works anymore. Do I still talk into this, into here? Is this the thing I use still?
You know what? You're like a stepdad that left these kids here, and Tom Martin came in and filled in for you. And then you show up. Hey, buddy. You've heard a lot of people. Especially Chris. You know, he looks up to you.
Look at these toys I got you at the gas station.
Chris said you're like his uncle.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You said that?
Yeah.
Is that because I...
If his uncle middled. Come on, let me get my insult out. I laugh at my own jokes.
I was going to say, is that because I'm fucking his sister?
Is this the way we open a show? All right, let's start. This is professional. Remember, everybody, don't act any different just because we're shooting it. Be very professional. Rolling the jingle.
A very funny guy, Todd Glass.
Can you pause for 1 second?
Back this time.
And stay back with that camera. I do not, if I go home and see this up close footage, I want to look so good. I want people to say that Todd Glass, he really looks good on camera. That's what I want. Anything less than that, I blame you. And this is the opening to the show.
Don't call me ever again, because we're done.
The Todd Glass Show launches August 12th.
Todd, hey, it's Zach. Listen, man, I really want to come on the podcast. I've got stuff to promote.
Comedy Central presents Todd Glass.
That's right.
Todd Glass. Ryan Regan.
Brian Regan, again, Brian Regan, Brian Regan, Brian Regan.
If you don't want me to do the podcast, let me know that. Do you want me to beg?
Todd, it's Maren.
It's exciting.
I'm the guy who can't come on the Todd Glass Show. What do I fucking need to do?
Be nice.
His very funny podcast, The Todd Glass Show, can be found at Nerdist.com. Please welcome Todd Glass.
From the beautiful Las Vegas.
Exciting. God, I can't believe it. Every week, no bullshit.
It's the Todd Glass Show.
Every week it's exciting because we do a real show. It's not like some of these other podcasts. Come on.
Well, I love to hear Todd Glass. I love to hear his voice.
Right into a song.
I love to hear him ramble on and on about things he's passionate. You know, it makes me feel good.
Can you pause that for 1 second? I feel bad that these camera people can't hear my jingles. If you only knew what you were missing.
Oh, I love to hear Todd Glass. I love to hear his voice. I love it when he prefaces every story so we know what he's talking about.
It's true.
You know, it makes me feel good.
Alrighty.
You know, I love it when he goes on.
Oh, wait, no. Well, this is the good part. I almost faded out.
It's wrong. Oh, I love to hear Todd Glass. Yeah, I love to hear Todd Glass.
Alrighty.
Well, I love to hear Todd
Glass. We're going
to
do what we do every week. We're going to go nice and slow. We're not going to rush. It's a fun day. Lynn Shore is here. Joey Zare is here. Joey hasn't been here for a long time. Lynn's over there. And then Watt is here. Go do your bit. Watt is here.
Who?
Watt is here.
What's his name?
Watt.
No, what's his name?
What?
What's his name?
What?
What is his name?
What?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking you. What is it?
All right, that's the first comedy piece.
Wait,
that's what you get.
I haven't been back in 3 months.
Hold on.
This is the thing I do.
I'm going to get to you last. You know who you get to last? The most important. Think about it. When you're introducing a big band.
No, I was just saying that people haven't heard me back on the show in a while, and the first thing I lob out is a modern parody of a Who's On First.
I don't care. I liked it.
Okay, thank you.
I chose the music didn't. Okay, so Mikey, the photographer's here. Katie's here. Eric is here, and Chris is here, and then Daniel Kino hasn't been here for a while.
Hey,
I think
guys.
A round of applause is appropriate.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
I think
you.
A round of applause is appropriate. And you know what? I'm not above rounds of applauses. Johnny, what are you doing?
I'm just talking camera.
Oh, Jesus! I felt it behind me. They're coming in. They begged us to shoot the show. Chris Hardwick called me on Thursday night.
Todd, please, it'll be so much fun, and we won't do anything behind. There'll be no noises. There'll be no buttons being...
All right, so that's that. All right, everything's going to be fine. Mikey's here. Chris is here. Daniel's here. Just go nice and slow. I don't want to hurry. This is what makes this show so special. Sometimes when they start shooting it, you think later. You go, why did I got myself wound up? The way I unwind myself is to remind myself not to get wound up, and that's what I'm doing. You can't do this on the show. Like, you know, you can't do this. Well, Regis used to do it. Take a cup of coffee. That's why people like podcasts, because it's you take your time with them. They're with you. They're not drinking their coffee going, what are we going to do? Take your time. Hold on. I'm not even joking. I slowed myself down today. I Ubered it to the drugstore, got some stuff, and then I was walking.
Wait, stop. You ordered a car from your house to the drugstore?
Yeah, my car is in the
what
shop.
What kind of money are you making these days?
No, my car is in the shop. It's $15 from my house to the gym.
And back?
And back. It's hard to hear. No, it's just $15 one way.
Right,
so
so
I needed to get to the gym, so I Ubered it. But then when I was going from the drugstore to the gym, I was walking aggressively, like I tell everyone not to do. Hey, I'm going to say it again. I said it a million times. There's times you have to hustle. I'm not negating that there's, you know, like when the waitress brings your order over and you need ketchup. Yes, I want to see you run.
I'm still hustle. I'm still on the image of like this limo driver who's probably like used to, you know, you take people to airport or meetings and then he pulls up and you're like, yeah, I'm just going to the gym. It's right up the street.
Yeah, they need money.
Yeah, I know it's okay, Todd, but you got to admit it's sort of funny.
No, I don't think it's funny at all.
It's just, it's, you know.
There's nothing funny about
it. He shows up in a suit and he's sitting there in your Adidas shorts. I'm just going to the gym right up the street.
Well, that's what Uber's great. You don't have to be, it doesn't have to be a special event.
I know.
It's all right. You tease me. I just tease you back.
Yeah. I'm just, I'm nervous that I'm hurting your feelings.
No, you can't hurt. Well, you can hurt my feelings, but you're not.
Okay.
Daniel, you're too close of a friend.
Oh.
We're working on a book together.
I know everything about you.
Oh, Jesus. I don't even
stuff you won't let Simon & Schuster put in the book.
Don't tell Daniel anything in person. A lot of stuff that I don't, nothing I did bad, but I tell Daniel stuff in confidence, and then he blurts it out in front of the other guy. I go, oh, one time. And then he goes, tell about all the money you used to steal at Dairy Queen. I'm like, there's no reason. It was wrong, and I made a lot of mistakes when I was younger. That and putting, well, we'll talk about it in the book. That's all I'm going to do now. I'll start the show every day. We'll talk about it in the book.
Oh,
no,
yeah.
We closed our Dairy Queen early one day when I was 16, and the girl across the way reported us to the owner. So we put, look, I wouldn't do this in hindsight. I really wouldn't. To George Carlin, as a full evolved adult, you realize you don't do things like this. But as a 16 or 17 year old, you do. So we put Ex-Lax in her drink. And we had the only bathroom. Everybody else had to use the mall bathroom. Our Dairy Queen in the mall had a bathroom in it. She came running over 25 minutes later to use the bathroom. That's right. Don't fuck with us. Go back to your dumb kiosk and be glad we let you take a shit in our Dairy Queen.
That's in the book.
That's in the book. That's chapter two. All right, let me not joke. Let's not joke around.
Let's not joke. God forbid we joke around on this show.
All right, so I feel like we do have a lot to rip through. And then, Daniel, I'm going to get to you because I'm curious. We see each other every day, but we just haven't been on the podcast. All right, so everything's good. How long have we done so far?
Like 10 minutes.
That's unbelievable. You know, if you think about what I do is I just took a minute's worth of comedy and I stretch it out into 10 minutes. And that's... And that's what a professional does.
You have a certain skill.
Thank you. Hey, by the way, Mr. Rogers, it was his birthday last week, and I thought, you don't just say happy birthday to Mr. Rogers on the day of his birthday. You celebrate every podcast for a month.
It's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy
feeling. Pause it for 1 second. You want me to turn this? This is an honest. This is either too dark, but I think it will. I'm going to turn this into a PSA, but it's not really the way this was on YouTube. It's just a cute kid singing a Mr. Rogers song.
Oh,
it's adorable.
I thought it was Victoria Jackson.
Who's that?
Come on.
From SNL?
Yeah.
Oh. So I'm going to turn this into a PSA. Okay, so go ahead.
You're growing inside. When you wake up, what did you say? I think I'll make a snappy today. It's such a good feeling, a very good feeling, the feeling you know that I will be back when the day's new, and I'll have more ideas for you, and I'll have things you want to talk about. I hold you. Thank you.
Killed by a texter 2 days later. Stop texting. What do you think?
The kid's fine, Daniel.
The kid's fine,
Daniel. It's a little dark.
It's a little dark, but it will stop. It will fucking wake someone. Well, you know what's funny? You can't wake people up any other way. You got to wake people up. How about if you were in the car and you heard that and you were texting? This cute little bundle of joy. You think it's too dark to do to a kid that's healthy and fine?
You know what I would do? I would text somebody. You're not going to fucking believe what I just heard.
You're listening to the Todd Glass Show, America, on the Nerdist Network. We'll be right back with some more comedy in your face. What if that's all we do now? All right, let's go. Let me rip through this stuff, and then I'll be happy, like we do every week. By the way, Eric, I like what you said last week. It gets the serious stuff out of the way first about they're so worried that if they let gay people get married, what did you say, that they're going to...
Oh, yeah, that we're going to be judged by God depending on the gay marriage or abortion, but not the millions of Native Americans we killed, the slaves that we had, the women we raped. But this might be what puts us over.
Yeah, no one talks about that. You've been judged by God. Yeah. You did a shitty job. Matter of fact, if you're worried about being judged by God, but that, fuck it, who cares? I'm tired of arguing. You're listening to the... Okay, so Alec, I can't say it. It's my friend's girlfriend, and A-L-L-I-C. This is so...
Alice?
Alec, or Al... No, it's...
Allie, shut the fuck up. I got you good, you son of a bitch. How about that? Allie, happy birthday. Philadelphia, go get a cheesesteak with me. Allie, happy birthday. Allie,
happy birthday.
God, that was fun. When my friend wasn't around, me and her had some good old fun.
Oh yeah, what happened?
I had fun. I don't know. Everything's fine. These are the shows I love to listen to when it's just slow and take it easy, right with our listeners. We're right there. You're listening to NPR, of course. I was saying today on the phone, NPR calms me. Just something about it. They go, we spoke recently to the governor of Colorado, and he sat down with us in a meeting and talked about some of the local legislation was going on, and we found out that some of the new rules coming up are blah, blah, blah.
You know what I think it's from?
What?
It's probably from being a kid and having it on, you know, in the mornings maybe.
My dad would listen. My dad listened to talk radio. But be the
I have that thing about the newspapers, like whenever I... I know you want me to do the bit that we did earlier. I don't remember how it went.
I don't like newspapers.
When you don't?
You know what? I do in distance, but when they're at my house, it's sloppy.
Oh, I like the crackle.
I know. I like my neighbor. I used to have a roommate that would read the paper and eat his eggs. Nothing. So relaxed. I'd be like, what the fuck is he so relaxed for?
Leisurely lifestyle.
Yeah, it is. He'd open the paper and eat his eggs, and then he'd read the paper more and eat his eggs. I'm like, finish your eggs and put your paper away and go somewhere. I wish I was lying. All right, we're gonna rip through it. Hold on. By the way, last week it was sent in by Jason Babin.
Yes.
I love that song that he sent in. It was a great song, and we didn't give him credit. We're gonna start really giving people credit. Jason Babin. And thanks for sending that song in last week. And then what else? Play a little Jesse, The Doors. Jesse sent this in. I like this. Do you have that? Play a little bit of that. Jesse W. That's your new nickname because I have a hard time saying your last name, Jesse W.
Here is another episode of the Todd Glass Show. Do you think it will be bad? Hell no. This show is so good that I might listen twice. I've met Todd before, he
there you go.
You know what,
Jesse?
that's a great song. You know what took me out of the moment is that you introduced it as a Doors song.
Oh, did I? And oh, that was the other song that was the Doors song. Who is it?
I think this is American. Oh, Green Day. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so Green Day. Who cares? What? Oh, go ahead, play it. I love it.
Oh, that's great.
I love it. Thank you, Jason. I hope I say Jason or... I never know if it's Jason or Jason.
It's probably Jason.
I made that up. All right, we're ripping through this stuff. I'm starting to get anxiety. Okay, I can't talk about that. Eric told me, I used to think LOL also meant lots of laughs. Right? Oh, no, I thought it meant lots of love.
Lots of love, yeah.
And you said that a friend of yours thought it meant lots of...
Yeah, my sister's friend, she thought it meant lots of love, so she would text things like, sorry your dad died, LOL.
That's not true.
Yes. By the way...
Do George Carlin?
Yeah.
Oh, I would do that. I thought it meant lots of love, too.
Oh, my God.
Now, I don't write LOL after shit, or I could have done that. Alex told me once, be careful.
You should do that. That's funny.
Shh, not a great idea for Zach, though. I want it. I lie to him.
LOL.
Okay, we're almost there to where I'm in the moment when I rip through this stuff. Okay, so by the way, Richard Malin, you have the best wife in the world. She wrote me the kindest email. I wish I would have known. They sent us all an invitation to the wedding. They sent you, they sent me, they sent Rory, they sent everybody here. But we can't go to the wedding, but
what
I thought
mean,
that was very sweet.
We can't go. Where is it?
Well, I have an invitation for you. Are you going to go? It's far away.
Where?
Are you going to fucking go?
I don't know.
Now you're going. And if he doesn't go, Richard...
Richard, I just want you to know if I'm not there, I never got the invitation.
Oh, no, you're going to get it. I have it.
Okay.
Gary Goldman was on David Letterman on, today's Friday. He was on Letterman on Wednesday night. I heard he did great, considering we haven't seen it yet because, well, we do the show on Wednesday and it hasn't aired yet.
Oh, he's on
tonight. He's
awesome.
Look, people know we do the show in advance. I don't know. Is that okay to him? Yeah, we people know that. All right, we're almost there.
Oh, my
there.
God. I'm so excited. That's
I know.
So
that's
great.
Exciting.
Yeah.
I told him. It's like one of the last things left in this business that's like doing the Tonight Show with Johnny.
I'm excited for Gary, too. It's so cool.
Yeah.
Gary Goldman.
Oh, look at Chris. All right. Is that it? I think I got everything. It's a choppy opening, but it's good. I'm doing a new song. I go around the crowd. Can you give me a little echo? I sing this. I walk around the audience. Bounce your boobies. Give it a try. Come on, ladies. Bounce your boobies. Hey, you. Come on. Hey, you. Look at you. Come on. Let me see your tits. Hey, come on. Bounce your boobies, ladies. What a fun night that's going to be. Because everyone feels safe with me now. So they're going to bounce their boobies, and people are going to want to come to I'm kidding.
Was there a real song under there?
We'll play it again. I'll show you. Come on, ladies. Bounce your boobies. Give it a try. Come on, ladies. Bounce your boobies. Give it a try. Hey, you. Why can't you bounce your boobies?
Oh,
and what's
God.
Wrong with your tits? Come on. Bounce your boobies, everybody. Come on. Let's have fun. It's the Todd Glass Show. Do you like it?
I love it.
I heard that, by the way, no joke. I heard that in the car. It was like must have been 1950s. And there's a woman, you know, you're listening on satellite radio. She's like, every guy I know has got a big stomach that's, give me a groomp after I, like when I give you, like, he's, every guy I know. It's probably 1960. And she's like an edgy performer. I'm not making fun of her. It was a different time. And it was very, like, maybe a sassy type of what she sang, but she was also funny too. She goes, every guy I know, everything's always sticking out. He's got a big stomach sticking out. He's got his big nose sticking out. Oh, you're right. He's got his big nose sticking out. But where he needs to be sticking out, he's not. Come on. Ladies, let's show him what we got. Bounce your boobies. Come on, what's wrong with you? And what's wrong with your... All right, enough with that. All right. I opened the show. You can take the reverb out of my voice.
That's... The first time Todd's ever said that, by the way. Can we?
Yeah, you're right. Sure I thought you were gonna say. I thought you were gonna say. I swear to God, I thought you meant bounce your boobies. One night on stage. Is this what I'm turning into? I'm turning into like a homosexual a cabaret act.
In your defense.
By the way, if I ever reference myself as homosexual, I want this whole fucking room to laugh because it's comedic. To think that I said that. You know how much that took. Even to comedically say it?
That's true.
We've got a homosexual here. All right, that's getting edited out. All right, so everything's good. Andy Kindler keeps calling. Never mind. All right, so that's good. All right, now here we go. Oh, we're doing great. All righty. So everybody take a deep breath. Everything's good. How you doing, Daniel?
I'm great. Todd, how
are
you?
Where have you been?
I've been at your house for
I know.
5 hours a day, every day.
And you did and you went to the Tonight Show tonight, right?
Tonight, yeah. A friend of mine's on the Tonight Show.
Did Jay come in the room and say hi to you?
Well, he came in the room and said hi to Justin, and I was there, and it was just very quick. It was cool. It's still cool, you know. It's Jay Leno. He's a giant.
You know what?
Very, very cool.
I make fun of Jay Leno. I don't think I say anything that mean on the show, but like then I thought about it the other day. Look, I don't want to be a wuss. Whatever I say, I mean, and whatever I say, maybe I shouldn't have said, I also mean. There's no one breathing down over me, so it's not like, oh, come on. It's like, no. It's like, But every time I've met him, he's been so nice and so I almost feel bad sometimes. What do I tease him about, though? Being in our air vent or something? Or I don't know. It's not that bad. So anyway, he has been.
It's a funny bit. Believe me, if Dave Letterman was easy to do in terms of impressions like Jay is, I think people would do Dave just as much, just say different things, and but still would throw it up, you know, for jokes. I don't think it's like anything against Jay that, you know, and I do anyway.
You know.
It's funny to do this. Look at how much fun we're having here.
Yeah, it's not going to hit anybody. Ugh. Listen here. Suck my cock. That was Johnny. I wish he was still around because I could picture him with a girl. Suck my cock. Anyway.
You know, he said that to girls.
I'm sure he did.
Bounce your boobies.
I think he said please. Bounce your boobies. Give it a try. I can't do it. I'll tell you. Bounce your boobies, ladies. Hey, I love that song. I really do. Anyway, well, guess what we have for the... So is there anything... So you were there and I'm sorry.
I appreciate your effort up this, what Daniel is up to segment.
Well, I'm upset with you because... Well, am I upset with you? No, I'm not.
No.
I'm just thinking if there's anything... You know what's so funny?
Yeah.
We have nothing to talk about because we see each other.
We've been writing your book.
Yes. I'm going to say the truth. I have a ghostwriter. I've never read a book. Now, that does not mean I'm not hiding.
Well, you're physically unable to.
I'm physically unable to, and because if
you've
you haven't
listened to books on tape,
if you haven't,
stuff?
I'm physically unable to write a book, and I think the crowd knows why. Because I don't know if you've ever seen the show visually, but you know. No. Anyway, that's all I get. Can I get a boom boom on the drums? Hey, I'll tell you, it's all right. Anyway, because I just can't write a book by myself. So not only do I have a ghostwriter that was hired, I guess you would say, through Simon & Schuster, but Daniel has been really, really helpful in this process in every single level. And I will tell you this, that Daniel, I'm the reason I'm not embarrassed to say
you did hire me. You are paying me.
Yes, yes. I am. What, you're afraid people would think that we were just friends and you were helping me?
No.
Ah, great. Now it looks like I just helped Todd. And I'm not reporting you to the tax.
True.
I'm not giving.
It's a gift.
Yeah, I'm not.
It's $75. It's tax free.
No.
And
no.
I get to.
No, Daniel has been taking the bull by the horns. And the reason I don't think I'm embarrassed to admit that not only do I have a ghostwriter, but I also. Because some people don't even admit they have a ghostwriter. That's right. What he explained to me. So it's not in the book. They don't get thanked. And I think that's when the ghostwriter really does write the book. Look, this book is in my words, it's every thought in my head. But to get them onto paper takes a lot of people.
We had to invent a process.
Yeah, and Daniel has been great with it. Matter of fact, Daniel knows me so well, I'm not lying, that sometimes I'll be trying to express myself, and Daniel goes, can I give it a shot? And he does it. I go, there you go. Whatever Daniel said. Like, it's better than what I could say. He's like, gets out of my head. Like, Paul F. Tompkins helps me with that sometimes.
Oh, that's
good. You know what? Matter of fact,
compliment.
I'm going to call him when you go to Malaysia, wherever you're going. Are you excited?
Yes. I'm doing shows in Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, Vietnam, and Cambodia.
You know, Joey Zare is from...
Huge.
He is.
KL.
Drop his name around.
Singapore. Yeah, I know.
He used to be a pussy magnet over there.
I know he was. That was like the first
sure
thing I've ever heard about Joey, like when we met at a party. Like, you know, he's huge in Southeast Asia.
All right, so...
That wasn't even a joke.
That's all right. Hey, thanks, Joey.
So if there are any listeners in that area, you know, if you can afford an iPod, maybe you can afford to come to the show.
What does that mean? I don't know what that means, honestly.
Well, because if someone's listening to the show on an iPod in Indonesia, you know, that's what that meant.
Why, did they not have iPods there?
I don't know. It was like a joke about poor people living in areas.
It's all right. Have fun.
Yeah.
That reminds me of my friend Burt Reynolds. Did I ever tell you about that, Todd?
What's going on here?
He went to Malaysia and made fun of people that don't have technology.
I can't believe him. Every week, he's had your microphone. He's had your microphone every week, but now that you're back, he doesn't. Mm-hmm. He just fucking went up to the PA.
I just haven't seen Daniel in a while. I thought he might like a story about Burt Reynolds.
Oh, hey, Eric. Sure, yeah. That was great. I didn't even know that mic was on. So what happened with Burt Reynolds?
No, let's go. Let's move on. Hey, by the way, we should fill you in. For this bit, we all ignore him.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know.
We don't give him anything. Hold on, let's do it again. We're going to do it real time.
When I
go like that, it means name drop again. Like, when I go, let's do it again. We're not done.
Wait, can I ask a question, though?
What? It's just so awkward that he interrupts.
Well, why does he have to go up there to do the bit? Like, since...
Be honest.
Oh, because, well, now we're taping.
Well, I forgot. No, I forgot that Eddie's going to have that mic, so I said during the show, you're going to have to go to the mic and do it. And to me, it's funnier. Now that it's only here, but he's walking over to a mic out of his way to tell us something that doesn't matter. And there's something very... Yes! What the fuck? Eric, hold on. Am I allowed to affectionately tell me what was in your head? That's. What? Let me tell you something.
Well,
let me interrupt you.
Okay.
Getting frustrated, you're never right. Because the minute someone explains it to you, then you understand. But I was getting frustrated. I'll tell you why. Because before the show, I said, when you're doing sound, sometimes I'm pointing at you and there's 10 things. But I said, tonight, it's good because when I point at you, you'll know that's just one thing to go up and name drop.
Right. And I ran up and I did one thing and then you said... Go, another one.
Well, that I understood.
Shit,
that I understood.
I had two back there, and I didn't.
Oh, you didn't. And then when you sat back down, I pointed back up there.
Yeah, but that's a lot of work.
So really?
To think of it, to think of names, yeah.
I thought it was an opportunity for you to showcase yourself on the show in a funny style.
It was.
So.
Okay.
By the way, but guess what? Still,
they went wrong the first time, and it threw me off. And then you said go again, and I just didn't have another name like that. Real fuck.
Anyway, I got a good. Now you were talking about Jay Leno, which was very interesting.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's interesting meeting him. And
did I ever tell you about David Letterman?
No.
Yeah, my friend David Letterman called me. He said Gary Goldman was going to be on the show tonight.
Does this, and now he's walking all the way up to that microphone.
Anyway, well, Justin was on the show, and it just...
Who were the guests of the show?
It was Josh Groban.
Josh Groban, yeah.
Yeah, Josh Groban is good, so I've never met him before, and so, you know, it's still kind of fun to see, you know, to meet somebody that big. You know, you think you're going to be too cool for school.
He's speaking of big celebrities, I tell you about Clint Howard. He's a good friend of mine that I hang out with. I could call him if you want.
What do you do?
I don't know. It's, you know, I don't even know who Clint Howard is.
Thank you.
It's weird that he would interject with that.
It makes me laugh every time I go to get a drink of coffee when Chris plays that. And all, if you wait two more seconds, by the way, consider what I just did. We're leaving that all in. Consider that, like, I love you, and I'm like your baseball coach. And I was like, sometimes, love you is a strong word, but you know that I think you have greatness in you.
My baseball coach loved me.
which is how he got a lot of these emotional problems he's trying to work through.
Do you know that I think you have greatness in you?
Sure.
Right. So because you know what I've said before on the show, don't be like, you know I love you. No, I don't. Sometimes. But with me and you, you know. So when I yell at you like that, it's because, like, I want you to, like, I think that's such a funny bit. So it's funny to me. By the way, screaming is never wrong. Somebody once said they had an acting coach that screamed and go, their ability to not communicate is never your fault. Never is your fault. But here it's a little bit comedic, I'm not going to lie, but it was frustrated, but then you can amp it up for comedic reasons. Yes. Bounce your boobies, give it a try. All right, everybody... That's not. This is what people are going to see. It's the first show we recorded. It looks like I'm a maniac. All right.
You are a maniac, though.
I am a little. No, am I?
Oh, Ned.
Well, oh, shut up. Own it. All right, well, listen. Today,
I have to pee.
Who doesn't? Okay, here's what we're going to do. We are going to take a break. I want today. You good?
I'm good.
You promise? What if I left the room for an hour and I was a fly in the wall? Would you say, Todd doesn't understand? Would you say that?
Oh, no. That sounds way too nice.
Oh, oh. That's your boobies. Give it a try. Hey, come on. What's wrong with you? Where's that?
I'm not. Well, everybody, we're going to take a break. It's going to be such a fun show. It really is. Eddie Pepitone is our guest today. We got all the business out of the way. And it is going to be a fun show. I like to go, you know, since we're recording, I'm going to go old style. We go to a break. What do we have to play and we go to a break?
Wake up every morning with a passion. I want to wake up with a smile on my face and be able to say I love what I do.
You can dream about it, or you go out and make it happen.
The Todd Glass Show on the Nerdist Network.
Okay. Eddie Pepitone, ladies and gentlemen. Yay.
Doesn't seem authentic.
It's beautiful. This is
Eddie Pepitone, ladies and gentlemen.
Does it hurt? Not hurt.
This is beautiful. Don't touch the candle.
No, the headphones.
Everybody,
headphones
head
okay.
Dance. Head dance. Head dance. Oh, man. Here we go. How about a hand for two guys with instruments? It's the name of their bands.
That's a beautiful. What a. That is by far the best entrance I have ever had, and I'm including television. This is a podcast, but I'm including television. I have never had an entrance like that, so thank you to everybody here. That was amazing.
Do you want us to do it again?
No.
Oh.
No. No, it's too much. You know what
it's
I mean?
Too much. Like, it's overwhelming.
It's overwhelming. It's like being loved too
Eric
much.
Eric wrote the lyrics.
And that's a terrific tag to the whole bit. It's a beautiful tag.
Eddie, you're a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you something. Before I got here, I got a yelling from Eric.
You
never
did.
Have I been talked to like that before.
Oh, life is so unpredictable. It's so unpredictable. I'm
so glad you're here.
Yeah, it's so unpredictable.
You look great.
Do I?
What do you use, like a raspberry facial?
I'm using a lot of products now. I get everything from the Apple store, including soap and body products.
You're very
products.
Progressive, you're saying.
I don't know if I'm progressive, but I like to do all my shopping in one place. How you doing, Daniel?
What else do you get at the Apple store besides
what else?
Soap?
Do you do all
your food shopping at
I
the
get
Apple
my
store?
My food shopping now at the Apple store. They have a nice selection of granolas.
You look well.
No, it's good that you ignored that. It's good that you were lost in the next bit. Yeah.
I'm not lost in anything. I have stuff for you. Whatever you say, I have something. Say it again. Say your line again.
And I also at the Apple store they have a nice selection of granolas.
You like it?
It doesn't seem to fit with what I just said.
Yes, say it again. Maybe I didn't play
it
loud enough.
At the Apple Store, they have a nice selection of granolas. It does fit. You're right.
Yeah, do it again. I need a little louder.
At the Apple Store, they have a nice selection of
Please
granolas.
Don't laugh through the... We're going to have to edit this, Mr. Pepitone.
All right, ready? I'm ready.
Mr. Pepitone, hi. I'm in the booth. That's why I make the bucks. People with money sit in booths and tell people over a PA what to do. the other people do what they're told. If you're in a booth and you're yelling, it's, you know, on the
set. Yeah, but can you see his wife going, Al, you're just a disembodied voice. Just because you make a lot.
Our guest
wait,
is
wait,
Eddie
where's that from?
That's from Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
That's right.
From
that's
what?
Right. Ferris Bueller's Day Off. I'm a
not
movie
a
buff.
Are you?
No. I'm not a movie buff.
You are a buff movie goer.
By the way, I know what's funny at home because I listen to the show. See this bit right here?
Yes.
You think, oh, and now fall. I always say the same thing. I never watch Family and Guy and go.
Family
and Guy. It's a new show. Yeah, it's a new show ABC's doing.
It's
you know
a
how
spin-off.
They always steal off. Yeah,
it's a spin-off of Family Guy. What if, Al, we do Family and Guy?
You're watching Family and Guy. Hi, everybody.
I'm one of the producers from Family and Guy. This year, we got a hell of a group of shows for you. Our star this year. All right, that's it. Let me go slow. Mm. I want this to be very special. Can I get a clock over here? So I like to... No, never mind. Never mind.
By the way, the religious I'm candles one of the best. Are
well,
off-putting.
It was an accident. Chris Hardwick brings them in.
He has turned super, super religious, right?
Well, no.
I thought he had. That's what I heard.
I think he's more spiritual, but I don't know. But
I
I'll
heard
tell you
religious.
What,
lack of spirituality, a lot of doctrine.
Right. So maybe this board, people think this board isn't a good, so here's what happened today. I don't want the studio very bright. So they've been.
I love what the atmosphere
I want it
awesome.
Too dark. I want them to look here. It's just
it's
the way I wanted
right
it.
Now.
Here's what's going on. When we took a break, they all looked into the monitor. It's too dark. I went, I know it's right then. That means it should be a little darker. I'll get it my way eventually. Mm-hmm. Eventually, we'll be here with flashlights on our faces. But Chris Hardwick shot in 15 religious candles. Oh, he has Johnny bring them in. But come on, look at this.
No, it's really nice stuff.
It's a little
really
much.
Nice I like it. I like
By the way, every time I see Josh, I think it's Chris, and he's running around the room because they look alike a little bit. Maybe not that much. Well, our guest is Eddie Pepitone. Please, this is my board. Oh. I aunt to George Carlin, I'm joking. I think it's funny. Chris has his board. How many times do I? Oh, you have better. Wait, why does yours have more bass than mine?
Oh, yeah.
Hold on, shut
better.
Yours off. Now play yours. All right, Chris gives me watered down versions.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, here's Chris. Oh, Todd, you'll love it. Play it. And then he plays his. Right. Eddie, let me ask you a question. Are you, I'm actually very serious. I wrote it down on my list of things to do. Are
circumcised?
You, do you try?
I am circumcised.
I thought you would be.
Yeah.
Are
In
you?
The back of a car, they did it.
They
did. It was for a commercial. I don't know if you remember
what
that.
What was the commercial for?
I forget what it was like the car. Oh, yeah, it was for a car, like a Cadillac. The ride was so smooth that you could circumcise somebody in the back seat.
Oh, that's right.
Do you remember that commercial? That's an old-timey commercial.
Were you a baby? Or?
I was a baby, and
you
I was the baby in the commercial, my first commercial I booked.
Uh-huh. Seriously?
I was baby getting his. Yeah, I had a circumcision like for
that.
Cadillac.
That was actually a very groundbreaking commercial because up until then, Jews have never been seen on television and acknowledged before.
Jews created television.
So yeah. That's true.
My uncle writes books about how Jews did everything. Seriously. So Eddie,
that's a shot at the Jews. Go ahead.
Thank you. Are you a spiritual? Do you try to be spiritual? I'm totally serious.
I do because I'm very angry. I'm very angry. Like, for some reason, I'm always stressed out. I'm serious as fuck. I'm stressed out every fucking day. And the only solution to it, I realize, I'm stressed out every day. Every day. I don't know why. Like, even as I've gotten more successful, and I'm not saying I'm a big success.
I understand.
I'm bigger than Apatow or whatever, but I... Fuck. No. No, don't go after Apatow, Eddie. A voice just said... but I am stressed out every fucking day. And what is the solution, man, besides drugs and alcohol, which I don't do?
Can I tell you? Can I introduce you to something I think you would like?
Yes.
I'm being very serious.
Yes, go ahead.
Would you like to meet somebody that can make you feel better? Seriously.
Yeah.
This person's going to rock your world.
Are you serious?
You're going to feel like the first time you meet a girl who's 20 years younger and you fuck her and it's fun. And you just, it's exciting, and you wake up and you want to have breakfast with that person. And you're
come
like,
here, baby!
And you come back from breakfast, and that's what this person's going to make. Oh, by the way, if you don't want me to introduce you, I don't want to introduce you. But would you like me to introduce you?
What would
it's called
be the...
Jesus Christ, Eddie.
Jesus Christ. Chris Hardwick is with him right now. He's doing his podcast tonight. Chris gets everybody. Chris got Jesus Christ. They're going to let him drive a moon raver, a rover.
No, that is a good.
I heard something.
That
from
is
Johnny.
A good question. If Christ came back, which he's supposed to do, and we're approaching Easter, whose podcast would he do first?
Seriously?
Yeah, I think it'd be WTF.
I'm not bullshitting you. Me.
You think it would be you?
Yeah. Because I spread more love than anybody else, proving you can be crass and still caring. If he didn't do my podcast, he's a fucking. It's a racket. That Jesus.
Well, it is a racket. So.
Well, I mean, if the real Jesus came, there isn't a real. What am I? And if the Easter Bunny comes, Santa Claus, they're all coming. Listen, I'm fine if they're coming.
Do you celebrate Easter?
I used to. I do. I'm going to be traveling. I'm going to be in Australia this Easter. I don't give a shit about Easter.
Do you think we ask good questions?
I think you ask the big questions.
Are you?
Easter and
we're,
Christ.
We're not afraid.
You're not afraid.
Well, we're taping the show. We want to make it more controversial. Is it true you hit a Jew in your car? We'll take a break. We'll be right back.
Yes, I hit a Jew. How could you not? It's Passover. They're all over.
Let me ask you some.
They are. I was driving down Beverly. They're coming in and out of the temple.
You don't have to make
oy! I'm like, get the fuck out of the way.
They don't say oy.
Oh, no. They never say oy.
Listen. Oy. If I.
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you a question, and then I don't want to get you stressed out talking about stressed out, because this is going to be a
no,
fun.
No, I'm fine.
This is
going to
be such a fun show today. Wait till you see what we have a treat for you. Lynn's going to do a song right here for you. Something special.
Really?
Live.
That's great.
We'll take a break. No. Do you like my new radio voice? Where our guest today is the funny Eddie Pepitone.
Right. I think you've mastered this medium and you need to move on.
This is all. You're right. I can't get any better.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I mean,
the way you do, like, first of all, you're such a visual person. The way you arrange rooms and stuff, you're a genius.
Thank you. But why do you want me to quit?
Because, no, there's no room for you to grow anymore. You know what I mean? The levels that you do on this show.
Hey,
no, just the audio levels that you do, the tags with music. The fuck you wasting your time for? Why don't you learn tennis some shit? Do something. You don't know what I mean? You've done this. You've done it. There's nothing else to do on this fucking plane.
Wait, Eddie, are you talking?
How dare you?
Oh, there's an actual song?
I like that.
Eddie Pepitone. A guest with bravado on today's Todd Glass Show. Pepitone. Eddie Pepitone.
Have fun. Do this.
Look out, shoulda, coulda, woulda. Here comes the bitter Buddha. Eddie Pepitone.
That brings me so much joy.
Because it's old school, my friend.
Pepitone. And again. Do it again.
Eddie Pepitone.
Can we get some live drums?
Pepitone. Eddie Pepitone.
Your young comics are afraid of this shit.
Like they really.
You know, your young comics are afraid.
That's the problem.
Like, they want to look cool. Yeah, I just got the new eye.
Eddie, if you could have done comedy in a different era, would you have?
Yeah.
Really? What era do you think?
The Jerry Lewis era, Dean Martin. Like,
I'll tell you why I disagree with you.
Rat Pack.
I'll tell you why I disagree.
I would have loved to have been a Vegas guy back then.
Hold on.
I became an alternative guy, you know, because of this era that I was born in. But I would have been amazing.
Do you think you have it in you, though? Like, wouldn't you have to be even less honest back then? You would have had to be even. Yeah, you couldn't be yourself the way you, real Eddie Pepitone, are. You couldn't be that raw and honest.
Thank
and
you.
You don't. Yeah, but you know what?
You would have been like Lenny Bruce. You would have been the outcast. And
well,
and
that would have been all right. I think it might have not even. You know, there was a.
There's two ways to go: Lenny Bruce or Jerry Lewis. And I'm being serious.
Mm-hmm.
Like Jerry Lewis took his seriousness. He was probably and from what I hear, he's a really overly serious guy. Mm-hmm. Is that you take that overly serious shit and you make it absurd? And I think I would have been an absurdist. I'm an absurdist, and you're an absurdist. I don't know if you're an absurdist.
Here's why I understand what
you
probably not.
Here's why, Johnny, what's wrong? Very nervous. Who's banging the table? Eddie, be careful.
Sorry. So sorry.
I run a tight ship around here. We have fun in the organized way.
But that does make sense, though. But yes, I know what you mean.
I would have been absurd back then.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay.
It just seemed like show business.
Wait a second. You said it was my turn, okay, and then I coughed, and you took my turn.
You're right.
Okay, everything's good. This does not look good on camera, but you can edit that out. Maybe you do something fun. All right, Chris.
What are we going to say?
Hold on, I'm getting a call from Chris Hardwick. He said, hold the religious candle up when I talk. They've decided that this is the only way they can see. Okay. Eddie Pepitone. I agree with Daniel. Maybe I'm just adding to it. Is he doing puppet acts? I agree with
you,
Daniel.
You have great peripheral vision.
I do.
And that's another thing you don't need to do anymore.
That's why...
you don't need to see out of your peripheral areas anymore. You've mastered it. Fucking move on. Do insulation.
I like to say my perif. I was on a plane. I saw a girl in my perif. I took that from Spade. I take a lot of little...
Is
I get
right?
a lot of habits from him. Like,
Is
when
right?
I can't think of something to say in my act, I always go, so that happened...
He does that?
That's him.
He does that?
Yeah, I tell him.
So that happened.
That's the difference between me and some other comedians. I call him. I go, I like that. I'm going to do it a little. He goes, all right.
I'm going to do it a little. That is a danger. You know, I've liked other things comics do, and I catch myself doing it once, and if I do it twice, I have to make a conscious effort. I am not going to do Louis' bit about masturbation again, or whatever it is.
I have a deal with some comedians corporate. You know, if you want to do my stuff at a corporate, may I God
you
bless
serious?
Your soul. Of course.
Do you
take
make them pay?
Take anything you want. I have that deal with two comedians.
They pay you, though.
No, just do
it. Oh, really? You give them that corporate shit?
I don't do corporate shows like I used to, so this is really...
Hello, Crest. People who make Crest. I am Todd Glass. You're more than a toothpaste. You're a cleaning system.
Is that me? No, not. I'm kind of going to do stand-up shows for them.
I know. That's your stand-up.
Oh, that's... I totally sell out.
And they love that. Yeah, you totally sell out. You totally sell out. Where are you going?
All right.
Oh, Crest?
It's good to be here.
Ah, thank God the comedian is up.
I heard this guy's pretty good.
I heard he's pretty good, too.
I'll tell you, you got to use Crest, you know? If you know, my neighbor won't use Crest. His breath smells. My friends want me to tell him. Are you shitting me? Are you fucking shitting me?
Hey, they're my kids who go to I'm training to be Crest people. Don't you fucking yell at my children.
Hold on, I got it. Is everything good?
Yeah.
So far, I really like this comic. Except he went after my kids. He went after my kids. I didn't like that.
Thanks for coming by the show. How you doing, huh? How you doing? Good to see you. Oh, you work here. How you doing? Thank you.
What a character. What a character.
Ah, I love this guy.
Can I tell you what I wanted? And we'll do this real quick. My whole life, I want a conductor that watches me. And then has to, stop the band. Like, he's, watching me, but then he's trying to control everyone else. And, I do it different every night, and he's sweating, you know?
It's a great thing to fuck with the conductor.
Yeah.
I would hire a conductor that was literally, I'd want him to look 100. To look 100 and tell me to go fuck myself all the time. I go, fuck you. Fuck you.
The conductor says
that? Conductor tells me to go fuck myself, but he's got to look old.
Yeah.
And he's in a wheelchair.
And he needs the gig.
He's in a wheelchair.
He needs the gig.
And I need him.
And you need
because
him.
Because with all his problems, he goes to the town. He trains the local orchestra.
Yeah.
I do need him. I don't want to retrain someone. So that's why he knows he can go, fuck you. A picture from a 100-year-old guy in a wheelchair. One of those electric scooters. Anyway... Why don't we do something nice for Eddie?
Yeah.
We have so many nice things for you. You're not going to believe.
It's already been amazing. I mean,
no, you deserve more. You deserve more.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Let's do this again. Let's do this again.
His mic's not on.
No, I think your mic's off up there.
By the way, this is how you fucking treat me.
Sorry.
Eddie, what would you like? We got something nice for you, and then it's a bunch of shit.
This is the type of shit that's keeping Tom Hanks off this fucking show, I'll tell you that much.
Hanks's people are like, we saw the Pepitone episode. They haven't worked it out yet, Tom. I would say
not
give
yet.
It another year. Year
not
ahead.
Yet, Tom.
Not yet.
Oh, no.
His but big I, manager. I want to like, not this yet.
Out. Hold on. Edit. Talk on your mic.
Hey, not yet.
Okay, there we go.
Should we leave this in
of
or what?
Of course.
We'll decide later.
Comedy we gold.
Hey, what were you saying about that movie, Meet Your Meat? But you said, what did you say? I got something ready for you.
Oh, I said, you know, don't mistake it for Beat Your Meat.
Very. There we go.
Because
anyway. Now that's
I planned that for you.
Yes, thank you. That's...
I want you to feel special. That's what I do, Eddie.
Oh, my God.
That's what I do.
Thank you. That was beautiful. And I'll tell you, that was a weird experience.
Why was it?
Well, first of all, to have a
Could
song.
Could you be angry? Were you angry during that song?
No, not at all. I was very conflicted. And I'll tell you why. Because Danny Boy, that song I love.
Wait, there's a song Danny Boy?
What?
You fucking prick. I told you to write an original. What were you?
I was going to chime in.
Danny, I know with you here, we both were like.
Fuck you. Fuck you. You're going to die in a year's time. That's how much time you have to live. Fuck you.
And then he turns to the audience. Anyway, he tries to play it off.
I would love to have that guy, but you'd have to really look old. Eddie. So during that song, I want to be a good host.
It was beautiful, beautiful song, and thank you. But I was conflicted because Danny Boy rips my fucking heart out as a song. Like, it's so fucking beautiful and sad to me. It's sad. It's about, isn't it about a guy losing his kid?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Right? It is. And so I'm thinking, I lost a child during that song. That's what I was thinking. I lost a child. But it was beautiful because it was about me. So then I rationalized I lost myself. And I went down
Maybe
this rabbit
will you
hole.
Do me a you bit. Are the lost child.
I am
Eddie.
The lost will you, child.
Will you do a bit? I know a lot of my bits I ask you to do, like to yell, but I, you know, I love it. Well, for this bit, will you tell me it went good, but then I hear you go in the other room, talk to somebody on the cell phone how horrible it was? Is that okay? But now you tell me it was good. Like, it's over. Then you got to go make a call in the other room, and I hear you scream.
You should have seen this.
No, 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 no. You'll literally go in the other room.
You want me to go in the other room?
Yeah, and you'll scream. But now you tell me it was good. Yeah, okay. But now.
So
hey, did you like that, Eddie?
I love that bit so much. It was the best thing I ever did. Can I make a call real quick?
Actually, we're going to take a break. Yeah, we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back.
fucking cocksucker.
Oh my God.
No, he says, oh, Eddie, we got a great song.
He's on the phone.
Does he not know we can hear him?
Listen, no.
About a lost fucking child. And I just lost a child at the Grove. That fucking cocksucker. No. It was horrible. It was a piece of shit.
Who's he talking to?
His wife.
I don't know what the fuck to do about this fuck. Yeah. All right. I'm going to go back to it. And I got to finish it contractually.
Why?
Of course.
Why is anger so funny to me always? Like, first of all, you're talking to, is that your wife, I presume?
I was talking to a friend.
And
yeah.
I figure it's your wife. She loves you. She knows you. It's not even a bad conversation. You know, she's like, well, just take a deep breath, you know, and she's calm on the other end. That's how I picture it. But what do I know?
Yeah. No, yeah, I figured I just had a yes man on the other end going, don't want just get through it. Just get through it.
Yeah, like Tom Martin was making fun of Elvis. You know, he had all those yes men around him. And anybody that really cared about him, that's who they, Elvis did, you know, they go, Elvis, I think.
Who was making fun of Elvis?
Tom Martin, a friend of mine.
Who the fuck was that?
He co-hosts the show sometimes. When Daniel can't be here, Tom comes in.
Okay.
Like everyone here, their stepfather. Like he comes in and I don't know. But listen. Oh, yeah, yeah. No wonder this show is the number one show. what were we just saying? Oh, we're talking about
the phone call and how anger's funny. You said you think it's
no,
funny.
Past
no,
there.
The yes man, Tom Martin.
Oh, yeah, Tom Martin. Elvis had all these yes men around him. And they probably anybody that really cared about Elvis that showed a little interest, you know, was let go. You know, like Elvis, I think he might be doing too many drugs. You know, yeah. And then he got let go. This guy got to stay, Tom says. If Elvis wants to take a nap in the middle of blue suede shoes, he knows what he's doing. He's a professional.
Yeah.
I love that. Like, so you know what happened. The reason that makes me laugh is because that means the night before, you know what happened. Elvis fell asleep during blue suede shoes. And this is this motherfucker. Then Elvis wants to take a little nap. Maybe he knows what the audience needs.
If he throws up on live television, it's supposed to be that way.
Yeah, he's a professional.
He's a professional.
Elvis is a professional. That's what he does. How would you like to... Daniel has a new bit. It's called 72 Questions. And he really takes... All right, that's that.
Okay.
Hold on. Just hold on. We have so much for you today. Why don't we...
I love the song, though. It's beautiful.
I didn't care for it.
Hey, fuck you!
Fuck you!
Fuck off!
Nay. Eddie...
Eddie.
I have a new song you can come out to on stage. I think you might like this. I'm being totally serious. Mm-hmm. What do you think? If you, ladies and gentlemen,
come out to, yeah,
Eddie Pepitone.
A clown, a clown. I think I'll be a clown. I think
love
I'll
it.
Make the people laugh.
Oh,
and
my
laugh
God. That is so
this
sick.
Is great. Where did you
and then
find
you do,
that?
You do one.
Where do you find these fucking
I have,
things?
That song breaks my heart.
No.
I love that song. Danny Boy kills me.
Wait, can I ask you guys a question about clowns and Jerry Lewis really quick? Can we back it up?
I don't know how much clown school is.
Oh. No, I was going to ask if you can write me a recommendation letter.
The floppy.
All right.
Do you guys mind? Wait, hold on. For real, do you know the Holocaust clown movie that Jerry Lewis
made? Oh, I've heard about it.
Made that.
I heard
it.
I still haven't seen it. I still haven't seen it.
No one's seen it, right? Like, it's like a ghost.
Oh, okay. Well, Patton Oswalt, I remember, did a live reading of it.
Yeah, some people got the script.
Yes.
Yeah, some people have read the script, but no one's seen the movie.
What have you heard about it?
He owns it. It's in the vault somewhere. And what is that? Because it's like a conspiracy theory?
No. I just like to play that. You haven't been here in a while.
So now you play someone taking a bong rip?
Yeah, well, sometimes if you say something very intelligent and then you play a bong rip, like say something as spiritual as you can say a quick words of wisdom. And then if you take a hit afterwards, it delegitimizes at your house.
Oh, okay. I just think that the absolute truth is whatever you accept in your life.
Because it ends up when you get the bong, you hold it because you know you're going to talk and then you want to take a hit. So sometimes if you go, you know, turn jealousy into motivation, you know. Whatever. I didn't want to take the time to do it. All right, listen. I want to go back to you, and I want to talk about the clown thing. So you could come out on stage,
I
you
love
do that,
that,
and get it set up again. You do like a joke, and then the music comes back in again. So I know you don't do one-liners, but maybe you do.
I think what would be funny, and you were talking about anger being funny, I think what would be hilarious is you know, if I go on one of my rants really angry, and then boom, that comes in like motherfucking idiots.
A clown, I think I'll be a clown.
I like the juxtaposition.
And you know what you do? Then you go over and you get a drink of water while this music plays. You pour it out of a pitcher.
That's what I'll
you know what I mean? You pour it in the pitcher.
Yeah.
Sometimes maybe you change your shirt behind a curtain. I don't know. I'm just trying to help you, Eddie. Just trying to fucking help you. I don't know what to do with, you know, so with you. All right, enough with that.
I don't know what to do with you.
It's my responsibility.
Bob, give me the clown song for Pepitone. Maybe that'll help his act, like you're a fucked up manager.
Yeah,
give me a clown song and get me a thing where he can change his shirt. He's doing Acme in Minnesota. I want it to go well.
A clown. Love this. Listen,
have you been doing a lot of road dates?
Oh. I have been on the road with with the movie about me, The Better Buddha Doc. And I just came back from like six cities. It was great.
Hey, by the way, it was great.
I don't like traveling that much.
What happens? You go to a theater and then, you know, you take questions.
Yeah, there's Q&A. Yeah.
There's Q&A.
And I use the Q&As now as to be funny. Like,
hey, do you mind a little betting music while you talk? Seriously.
So I used, yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
A betting music?
Yeah.
Once I did a few, I realized I could be funny during them.
Now, how did it affect you, like, you know, having, and since both your parents died in a tragic car accident while you were promoting the movie?
Yes, it was a head-on collision. They didn't see him coming. It was one of those foggy, foggy nights. And boom, both my parents gone. And
the
you
school
know,
bus, they collided with a school bus that exploded.
So many children dead. So many children gone.
In a hookah accident. Last time you were on the show.
In a what accident?
Last time you were on the show, you said you were upset because these kids, that you found out money that you were backing was some kids. There was a hookah factory explosion.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it was something.
I don't like the hookah bars they have where, you know, these long fucking things come out of tables.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, oh, we're just puffing on scented something.
It's
fuck yourself.
Go fuck yourself. I agree. I agree. It's like, it's not, you know, it's not cigarettes. It's not pot.
No.
Is
it
bad
for you? It's the same as oxygen bars. No. Go fuck yourself.
Who needs oxygen?
Hey, my mom manages an oxygen bar.
Let me get seven oxygens. I'm Millie Glass. And if you don't listen to me.
Millie Glass.
I'm Millie Glass, damn it.
My mom manages an oxygen bar. The outside's really fucking with her business.
My husband is Arnie. It's Arnie and Millie Glass, and we put all our money into this oxygen bar, and goddamn it, it's going to go. It's going to go, or we don't have a house anymore.
Hey, people do that. That's why on that restaurant makeover show, you know, people put their whole life savings into the restaurant.
Oh. Fucking idiots. No, they are.
By the way,
they are. If you put your money in a fucking restaurant, you're a fucking idiot.
Well,
if
you don't have it, you're probably right a lot of times. But in other
restaurants are such a... Don't put your money in that. Put it in the Apple store. They got the iTouch. No, I'm serious. You got a product. You got a product. And it's a beautifully designed store. Now, you're always talking. It's a beautiful white store.
It is.
I like the guy who's like describing the Apple product as like the new thing to get in on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that's... That's where the smart people are putting their money in. You know, these Apple stores are so sleek. They really figured it out.
I really am at that stage because I bought a computer and an iPad yesterday, and I'm all about the Apple.
Look at me. I got an iPad. That's how I can do things. But don't put your money in restaurants.
Let me talk to the people. There's a camera. Don't put your money in restaurants. It's Always Sunny in Philly is a bullshit show. It is. You know what I mean? No, those people promote, we're running a bar. It's all fun and fucking games.
No, it's not.
No, it's death. Usually people take their lives when they run a restaurant. They take their lives.
Well, I don't know if that's a real statistic.
They take their lives in the kitchen. They do.
You mean financially drains their lives. And
they take their lives for real.
Well,
you have not been in a diner and heard a gunshot? Go fuck yourself. No, I'm serious.
So it's just the owner's in the back. He's getting tired.
Yeah, the owner's in the back.
Two eggs over easy.
Boom!
Oh, that was good.
There goes the owner, Bob. I guess we got a short shift tonight.
Everybody out.
And all of a sudden shit starts coming out of the walk-in freezer. Where you going with that tuna, Al? Well, Frank took his life. I might as well take the rest of the tuna. They're overfishing the ocean anyway.
That doesn't make any sense.
I know, but he rationalizes anything.
Exactly.
They're overfishing the ocean. They're killing sea turtles for this tuna. Of course I'm going to take it home and grill it. No, but the only place
they're overfishing in the ocean.
Yeah, they're overfishing in the ocean, and they don't make good VWs anymore. That's why I'm taking a tuna.
One time, speaking of, you know, they're a diner and they keep, you know, you wonder if they're going to stay open or not. Geno's in Philadelphia.
The Philly steak place.
Yeah, they the owner.
Next to Pat's.
Yeah. And by the way, if you're listening and you're friends with him, this is funny for the right reason. He died, and obviously a lot of people that love him were sad, and Blake Wexler said he went down there, and they were still open the night he died, serving cheesesteaks.
That's too fucked up.
Listen, serving cheesesteaks.
He would have wanted it that way.
Serving cheesesteaks while they were crying. He goes, I swear to God, Todd. I don't care if tears aren't pouring out of the eyes, but visibly upset.
No, but tears
he goes,
are
crying, tears coming out of their eyes.
No, do you know that tears are the way you spread fucking viruses? I mean, you know how many people got sick that night?
Do you have to
you
take it a horrible direction?
Oh, that's so
my
horrible.
My beautiful story.
Because yeah. I'm related you know, to doctors, I get fucked.
The first person to get AIDS was actually consulting someone that was really upset. And that's how they
the first person who got AIDS had a Philly cheesesteak on a night of a terrible tragedy.
It's all edited.
And I'm not saying Pat died or Gino died, whoever those
guys. Wait, hold on. So they were crying, but they were made to go into work. So they were.
Yeah, but because, you know, they knew he'd be like, I don't care if I'm dead. You work. You work. And maybe they were right. So maybe they had to, by showing him, because he was probably, you stay open. That's what we do. So they probably were crying. I just couldn't eat a cheesecake. Could you eat a cheesecake if someone's serving
cheesecake
it?
Cheesecake or cheesesteak?
Either. But I did mean cheesesteak. Can you eat a cheesesteak if someone's serving it to you crying?
Yes.
I feel
yes.
It's good.
Yes, I could.
I've taken a lot worse things from people there. Yes.
Name three. Go. This is for the Cadillac.
Wait, what do you want me to name? Three what?
Three things that you've taken from someone while they were crying.
Oh.
Three things.
Money, sex.
No. What kind of person
are
you?
Sex I have had while someone else was crying as well.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have. Who hasn't?
Yeah.
You're joking, right?
No, come on. You have never had sex with the crying person. You're missing out,
my
friend.
Well, no, it was me crying.
Because that's when they
open
up. I was
very confused.
I don't know.
What are you laughing at? What are you laughing at?
It's a funny thing to say.
He's funny. Eddie's funny. Sure he's funny. That's why I have him on.
When they start
that
crying.
Would be funny.
When they
what
start
are you
crying.
Laughing at? All of a sudden, you're the guy who doesn't get any joke. What are you laughing at? What the fuck are you laughing at?
Oh, yeah, that's
like,
not nice.
What
are you laughing at? Oh, that's not good. What are you laughing at, Eddie?
Huh?
There's a reason. Can we turn this around here?
What the fuck is that?
Well, maybe you deserve something nice.
It looks like an asshole machine, by the way. I would call that an asshole
Eddie,
machine.
Can we get a shot? We'll put this in post. That's showbiz talk.
For not doing it.
Eddie, wait a second. What is it? What did you say? When I hear everybody,
well, people always go, "Well, we'll do it in post." I'm saying that's showbiz talk for not doing it.
Right, for not doing it now.
No, or, not doing it at all.
Not doing it at all because
I'm
you never do
joke.
It in post.
You never do. Yeah, you're right. That's a nice way to say, "Hey, you know, the girl goes, I didn't come." You go, "We'll do it in post."
You have been with you have. Oh, that shows me you have done
that
sex
is
with
funny.
People crying. Sex with people crying, by the way, is a fetish site on a porn fetish
uh-huh.
site. Sex with people crying.
Is that true? I'm sure it is.
Eddie,
I don't know why that's making me laugh.
We got something for you.
I'm sure that's a site too.
I want you to know that, Eddie, what you do to make people laugh. I put together. I know. By the way, let me say this to George Carlin. I'm being serious.
To what?
To George.
Oh, no, right.
Yeah.
You swear to George Carlin. Yeah. I mean, pray.
We have a lot of stuff on the show from you. We have a bailouts. Do we have the bailouts on there by any chance? Well, you know, remember you talked about the bailouts? Letty, that idea gets us out of so many bits. What? Play it.
How does that go again?
We had a jingle made. You said, we're the bailouts, folks.
We're the bailouts.
So we put a little.
I love it.
Bitter Buddha. This is what I was going to say. I know sometimes compliments feel good, but mm-hmm. I always say it's also awkward to get them. So just sit there and take it. You don't have to.
I've learned to do that through this movie process.
It's but it feels good. But I know what you
it
mean
does.
It's awkward.
It
but
does
no
feel
one's
good.
Denying it feels good. But you don't know what to do during it. So
yes.
I'm going to tell you, just do whatever you got to do. I don't care if
okay.
you close your eyes.
Go ahead.
Bitter Buddha is fucking great. It really was. He's jerking off. Oh, I guess they don't. Eddie,
right, go ahead.
Well, that's good. Well,
It was really great. It was just, you know why? Because if you knew about you, it was interesting. And if you didn't, you learned about you. A lot of documentaries, I have to be honest, you walk away, you're like, I didn't really laugh. It was a lot about that person. But you're like, you see how funny you are. And it just wraps up great. That was,
yeah. I really liked it. I didn't watch it for, like, because it was hard for me to watch. And I watched it in our last city we went to, me and Steve and the director, Stephen Fine Arts.
Stephen Fine Arts. And by the way, it's so sad to see a guy young like that pass. But... you know,
took his life in a diner.
Took his life in a diner. He took all the money from Bitter Buddha. He opened up a diner.
All the money from Bitter Buddha. He sunk into a single flavor yogurt stand and took his life.
A single flavor yogurt stand.
That's all. And the flavor was a fuck up on his part. It was mango pomegranate.
Oh,
and people were like,
no.
Get the fuck out.
If you're
going to
go with one flavor, go with vanilla.
Go with vanilla or chocolate. But he was like, oh, pomegranate. He's got the oxidation bullshit. And he got fucked big time, took his life.
But so anyway, I think Steve Fine Arts, the reason...
But he kept that thing open, and people were crying serving single flavor.
You know, if you serve vanilla ice cream, Rory Scovel had a good idea. He said he's going to have a truck full of toppings, and then he's going to follow the ice cream truck and then say, I have toppings. So just... You know,
and then, there's a guy who will make it in a sluggish economy. What's the kid's name? Scovel?
Well, he's a comedian.
Scovel?
Rory Scovel.
Scovel. He's going to do very well when the comedy falls flat or whatever happens to him.
Whatever happens.
Because a lot of people lose their voice in comedy, and then they have to go into following trucks. With trucks.
So listen, I put something together
anyway,
for you.
The
documentary
was
beautiful.
Yeah, but I really did like it, and it was a great job.
Steve did a great job.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Steve Fine Arts.
It's a really good
You show
good
him
movie.
Respect?
What?
Do you show him respect?
I do, yeah.
This is a kid that thought you were hilarious. I always get jealous of that. Somebody woke up and goes, I'm the only one besides you. It's me and Steve Fine Arts. We're in love with you. And
you're the only other
I'm the
one.
Only other one. No, I would be that I might be one of look. I hope you have a million fans, but I could be one of your biggest fans. You get me to laugh like it's that punch a fucking hole in the wall. That's a great feeling.
Yeah.
That's
a
great
feeling.
Well,
we do that for each other because you do the same
you
for
don't
me.
Gotta
and you're
say
an
that.
Amazing.
Keep going.
Now, I'm gonna now turn it and see how you can take a compliment. You are an amazing, amazingly funny man. And I tell people because, you know, people have heard the couple episodes I've done with you and they're like, you guys together, so fucking funny. And I say every time, and because on the road when I'm doing stand-up, people say, oh, I heard you on Todd Glass, da, da, da. And I'm always like, yeah, well, Todd is so fucking funny. And they always go, all of them go, I don't think so. And they walk away. No, they go, yes. They go, yes, yes, I know you.
Well.
So you're one of the funniest.
It seems like you're stretching it out.
That's how you take
mine. Went a lot longer. All right, I went on and on. I know what you were doing. 5 minutes in, you start.
This is like a weird Passover Seder. Okay, Frank, you come and compliment me until Elijah shows up. You come and compliment me about how I built a business with my bare hands. With no help from your mother, who took a life serving a certain type of egg.
Listen, here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to do the guy who wears a toupee and doesn't want to admit it. And you're going to be great at this. I'm so excited.
I've never done this.
Well,
I'm a little
Are you a little
nervous.
Nervous?
I've never worn a toupee. I'm a little nervous.
It's just I love
Is there someone to watch over it? Like, you know, like is there like a guy who like an animal because a toupee reminds me of an animal. Like, you know how animals on set, they always have the handler? Mm. Is there a toupee?
Oh, a toupee.
Like, yes. No, move it to the left or whatever.
We have a guy that's going to come in or a girl, whatever you want it to be, and place that on you. So we're going to take a quick break. Eddie Pepitone is our guest. Why don't we go out of here with something nice, something different, something they've never heard before.
A clown, a clown, I think I'll be a clown. I think I'll make the people laugh and laugh all over town. A clown, that's what I'll be, a clown. Sometimes I feel when I'm afraid that I will never make the grade. So I pretend I'm someone else and show the world my other self. I'm not quite sure of me, you see, when I have to make a clown of me. A clown,
a clown. I think I'll be a clown. I think I'll make the people laugh and laugh all over town. A clown, that's what I'll be, a clown. Sometimes I feel all good inside and haven't got a thing to hide. My friends all tell me I'm the best. They think I'm better than the rest. It's times like this I act myself, and I let the clown stay on the shelf. Myself, myself, I think I'll be myself. I think I'll let the people see the comfortable inside of me. Myself, I'll be myself. It's only when I feel let down, I might be scared into a clown. But he can be himself when I can be myself. Myself, I think I'll be myself.
All right, so you want to sing a song to bring us back
to
the commercial?
It's just an old Bobby Darin song, and I hope people like it.
You want reverb?
No. It's an old Bobby Darin song, and he would do this right before Mac the Knife in his Vegas shows. All the indigenous people have been killed, have been killed. All the indigenous people have been wiped out, wiped out. And it goes on. It's a beautiful.
That's one of my favorites.
Fuck you!
I got to be honest with you, Eddie.
Yeah.
And we've been friends a long time.
And I love our friendship, and you're an amazing comedian. You're a beautiful comedian. Beautiful. Well, I mean, you know what the thing about you is? You live it.
By the way, this guy knows what he's up against. He's trying to overcompliment me. That's what I think. But guess what? He doesn't win. Well, thank you very much. That's very kind.
You live comedy.
Can I tell you, that's why I probably am
comfortable. Your life is absurd.
Thank you. But
I don't mean that in a bad way.
No, I get it. I appreciate it.
It's just an absurd fucking life that's insane.
That's probably why I'm comfortable talking to you about what I'm about to talk about. Because it's uncomfortable for me.
What
but
is?
I'm a friend.
What is?
Honest? Can I be honest with you?
Please do. I've been through years of therapy and meditation, motherfucker.
Okay.
Bring it. Okay. Bring it, bitch.
Listen. All right, you don't get it.
I'm sorry.
You're making me nervous.
I'm being over-aggressive about...
A little bit. But it's
something
okay.
That's going to be delicate, probably.
I want to talk to you. Thank you. I want to talk to you about something. And if you don't want... I'll tell you why I want to do it on the podcast. And if you're uncomfortable with it, we won't air it. We won't air. But
are you
a lot
being
of
serious
people,
about
yeah,
that?
I am. I actually am.
Okay.
But there's a lot of people out there that are going through what you're going through. And I think if we talk to you and find out why you do it, that it might help other people. And Daniel primarily wanted me to ask. I'm such an asshole. I throw him under the bus.
But hold
Daniel
on,
wanted me to ask right, you this, right, and I think he's right.
You know what? You know what's killing me right now?
What
is
it is.
I actually have no fucking clue.
Yeah, I know.
And this is for real. And this is for real. And I'm saying this to the camera. I have no fucking clue. What is making you so uncomfortable? And it's weirding me out a little because I think you're a beautiful comedian, a beautiful, beautiful comedian.
You have to. People know you're wearing a toupee.
Excuse me.
Is
this a fucking? What are you fucking talking about? This is my hair. What are you fucking talking about,
Eddie?
I swim with it. What are you fucking talking about? You want to pull it? I mean, that's fucking... I'll tell you something. And if Daniel said this, fuck you too. That's rude. That's rude. And this is, you know...
Okay.
I don't know what you're talking about,
okay,
dude.
Eddie.
This is my
Eddie,
hair.
It's not
I've
your
always
hair.
Been blonde.
I'm not trying to make you... Oh,
fuck you. You saw the movie.
Look
I've
at
always
it.
Been blonde.
Can I come over and look at it?
I'd rather not. I'm a little touchy, but you can touch it if
well,
you
can
want.
I come over there and touch it? I'll let you touch
yeah,
me.
Yeah, but
Eddie,
don't pull...
Hold on. Now I feel like you think I'm trying to be mean to you. I'm not. I'm your friend. People look at that. They know.
You know, by the way.
I know what it's like. You're holding on to this lie. But, Eddie, we love you to death. Just admit it. I've done vain things, too. It's just I can't let you be a buffoon. You're not a buffoon.
This is my hair.
You're not a buffoon.
This is my hair.
Eddie.
And I don't like this line of questioning. You know what I mean? No, because
you
it
were
insults
bald
everything.
You
I'm
were,
a bullshit.
You were bald.
Bullshit.
I have pictures of you bald.
You have pictures of me bald?
Yes.
If you produce them, maybe I'll be like, oh. But let me tell you something. People's hair grows back if you eat a certain diet. I've been really, what?
Eddie. I'm look.
I
want
like how you coat this.
Can
I
tell you?
Like how you phrase it. I'm your friend, Eddie.
Okay. Can you let me get? You have to get this in because I think I'm feeling worse than you. Part of me wants to back down and apologize, but I can't let my friend, who I know is brilliant, walk around with that thing on your head. It's a toupee, Eddie.
It
Stop.
Is not a fucking toupee.
You swear on your. You swear.
I swear on my mother. I swear on my father.
That's real.
That this is real.
Can I come over and touch it? Seriously, I'm not going to pull it. I wouldn't pull people with real hair.
You can come over and touch it.
I mean, Eddie, I feel did like you, I'm trying. I feel
do
like
you
I'm
not think it's real? I'd like to take a... Here's what I'd like to do before you touch it. One by one, we go around who thinks it's real, who thinks it's not, and I bet more people know it's my hair. Who thinks it's my hair? Who thinks it's a toupee?
I'm... Hold on 1 second.
Well, I...
Hold on.
What does Daniel think?
I remember when I first met you, I had an image of you as having... No hair. So
and
maybe
you were surprised.
So
there was a look of surprise on your face. It's like when you order a Denver omelet and you get a plain omelet, you're like, whoa, where is the ham and pepper?
I suppose, yes.
Well, you're missing the point. So, get to the point.
So I guess I'm a little surprised now.
Why?
A few years later to see you with a full head of hair. And I guess you had your head shaved back then or something. I just didn't know.
I may have been going through a phase.
What kind of phase?
I feel like
just
we're ganging up on you, Eddie.
I wanted... You know, a different... I go through a lot of phases, but
Eddie,
this is my hair. Fuck you. Can we go around and see who thinks it's my hair and who thinks it doesn't? Because you're wrong.
I'm famous for liking to stop bits and send them another direction. So with that in mind, we're going to go around the room. Do you want everyone to lie for you because they're all chicken, or do they be honest? You pick.
I say people say it's real.
Oh, yeah, that's how much. No one here is being honest with you. And they all throw me under the bus.
I say everybody say
hey, guys,
it's
you
got
to back me here. Like, Daniel, do you... Well, you've said it. Thank you. But what about... I mean...
Yeah, I think...
Thank you.
It looks like a young Tom Petty.
He thinks because your documentary's doing good that he's going to fuck it. I love you to death, and you don't look like a young Tom Petty.
Oh, really? Because thank you very much. Thank you, Chris, because I've gotten that more than once. Yeah. You know, no, let's go around.
Come on, be honest.
Younger than Tom Petty.
Be honest.
Thank you.
I think it looks real. I think it looks great. Like I like the product you're using in it.
Why are you
fucking throw me under the bus like
really
this?
Good.
Chris, thank you, Kay.
Eric, we have talked about it. You said we love Eddie to death, and we owe Eddie to be honest with him.
Hold on.
Let me get this out. I feel like I'm the bad guy now because I'm now getting defensive. This was from such a place of love. Saying the truth, what you said last night.
I think what your confusion is, he had his hat on when he first came in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And that does throw people.
Shut the fuck up. That might be it.
Boy, I have never seen a guy. Now, I'm serious, and I mean this in all... No. Let me turn the tables on you. I've never, and I mean this in all sincerity, I've never seen a guy defend a wrong fucking perception like you. I'm serious. I've never seen a guy. Like, you ever see a guy on an acid trip who's like, oh, shit, the tree is talking, and you know he's full of shit? And then he gets all defensive, like, all right, I was on acid.
Just say something, you know, now that I'm sitting really close to you and I could sort of tell it's obviously your real hair. I'm sorry, Eddie. I don't know why I even brought it up.
Thank you, Daniel. What do you – yeah. Yeah, it's fine.
Eddie.
Yeah. Go ahead. Go ahead.
I understand this is from a place of love. Like, you can't do this to yourself. You're better than this.
They're kissing my ass. They have nothing to gain by kissing my ass.
I feel like now I'm turning into like a bad TV show to get the ratings. Get a close-up of that motherfucking hair and show that, if you're not embarrassed.
I am not embarrassed. This is my hair.
Fuck you, you fucking punk.
I am a natural.
Fuck you. You look like a fucking something.
And I owe you a fuck you, but you look like Robert Redford.
Who's that?
Thank you. Thank you. And
who is that?
Yeah, I mean, I feel attacked. Guys, I feel like these people are being honest.
Joey, I'm definitely real.
Joey, thank
he
you.
Looks like you're Joey's young, and look at his hair. It's real.
Joey's hair is real. My hair is real. Eric's hair is real. Steve's hair is real.
Stop it. I know what you're doing. I don't care if you can keep saying
Daniel's hair is real. There's a pattern. Your hair is real. There's a pattern. Right. It doesn't move, right?
It doesn't move,
you idiot.
I'm being nice. I can pull it off.
You're
right
being
now.
Nice,
you
huh?
You seem like I'm a maniac. I can pull it off and I'm being...
You can't pull it off. Go. Pull it off, asshole. If you can.
I'm not a fucking...
All right. I'm sorry. I was lying. You're right about that. I was trying to pull it off. And I'm sorry. Hold it. I have an apology to make. I'm sorry I fooled everybody. I'm sorry I fooled everybody but you. No, that it isn't nice to do what I did, which is pull a prank. And I am sorry. I want to apologize to the other people who thought it was real. Todd has a finer eye than you. No, you have a terrific eye. You have a terrific eye. You have a terrific eye.
Eddie, I swear, I thought you were going to do it, like, still deny it, and I was excited to see that. I was excited because I knew, but this is a compliment. I knew that Eddie, I had a feeling you were going to still go. Even after I ripped it off, you were going to have the nerve to go, oh, ow, like I put your scalp off.
That would have been funny. That would have been funny.
So when you went the other direction, but then I ended up fucking liking that, too.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Oh my
the key
God.
To going in.
Thank
another.
You is a keen eye. So it ends up they all look like buffoons. And you trust me and we open up a business together. We're rich. They all sat because you knew I was the one being honest with you.
You
that,
did.
By the way, that was hard. Because a little bit we got too real. Like I'm like, oh, yeah.
Did sad. It really?
Well, yeah, you go, yeah, it's real.
Oh, have you ever won a toupee?
This is one. Bing! No, I've never won a toupee.
No.
I don't know why I act offended. Well, because
I like wigs, though. When I used to get high a lot in Brooklyn, I used to wear crazy wigs and run into barbershops, like old man barbershops with a crazy wig, and take a British accent and go, hey, man, how much for a haircut? And run out and be really high. And the guys would, get the fuck out of here in Brooklyn. Those were the days. That's when I was.
Were you with other people?
What?
Were you with other people?
Yeah, I was with a girlfriend at the time who thought it was really hilarious. She would have wigs. We'd just go around Park Slope with wigs.
That's hilarious. I got lost there for a second. You could still do that.
Yeah, that'd be what fun to do.
Well, I'll tell you what.
In this neighborhood, it would be great to do at the Grove, you know, like run into La Pan Quiddidon and go, hey, man, how much for the croissant? And book out. But always do it in a British accent.
I want to go to the Grove.
How to have fun in the Grove is a three-week course.
Me and you should be in a... Do you have any crackling sound? Like an old-time cops. Remember, people go, they love Eddie and Todd. Maybe we could be...
Two cops?
Yeah. We're like an
Which
old...
Which kind of cop
well,
are
I'm
you?
Talking about old school. Do you have any, like, make it sound like it's 1940, we would have had a show.
Is this a radio show?
Yes. I got nowhere to go. I got nowhere to go with this bit. I have everything but the idea. I got the music. I got
hey,
the
is that the motherfucker who hit up the liquor store before?
I think it is, Bobby.
No, wrong. Nah, that's right. Not the guy. Oh, that's not the
you're
guy.
You're right. I thought it was.
Bye. Boy, out.
Why are you talking to each other on the phone?
Hey, by the way,
you're not talking on the phone. We're in the car, and you're hearing both of us talk next to each other.
Oh, but he sounds fine, and you sound.
Well, I like.
By the way, that would be hilarious if we were on the phone, and I'm going, "Is that the guy?" And he's like,
"Daniel
I
knows why." And it's really rude.
What?
Okay, I really like using this, so sometimes I'm willing to use it, even if it doesn't make sense.
It took me out
because
of the bit.
Because it's so much... I'm kidding.
I know.
It took me out of the bit.
No, I felt like
I'm
going to
be
so
honest with you. It took me out of the bit.
I'll be honest. I love this machine. If I don't need it. I use it for any excuse. So I was at the bakery.
Hey, 2 donuts, please.
You know, it sounds
better. It's a great
machine.
He called AT&T and he asked that they make him sound more phony on the phone. Like
yeah.
More...
Like old school.
It doesn't sound like I'm on the phone, sir, but most people prefer that. No, I wanted to sound like I'm on the phone.
Did they do it for you? That'd be funny if, like, just one moment, sir. We're just programming that now.
$9.99.
Try it now. Try it now, sir.
If we have to make an edit here, I'm fine doing it. Can you sing I Will Survive with Lynn and you'll take one course and he'll take the other?
Yeah, I guess so, sure.
Would you do that?
Sure.
Is that pressure?
Not at all.
Would the word out on the street be, you know, I love doing Todd's show, but last time I got him in, he threw me into these, like, to write a whole sketch.
Yeah. No, I'm fine.
You're fine?
Yeah.
That's why you're good.
I'm
these
good.
Other pussies come on this show.
Oh, do they get scared?
Yes, they go, oh.
Well, their management is looking after them.
Besides...
Don't do anything you're not comfortable with on that kid's podcast. It's like over a car dealership. Who knows what the fuck goes on?
I like it. I like you saying I'm a kid. That's why I hang out with Bud Freeman. He still calls me son.
Does he?
Oh, yeah, Lynn. Oh, wait, so why don't we turn it around and they'll do it over there?
Do you think that's because he's
Lynn,
your real father?
Can you then have your... is there a, yeah, maybe you can use his mic.
Oh, you want me to sing the real words?
Yeah, and then he'll just take over their chorus and do whatever he
wants.
Is
this the words here?
Yeah.
So we're doing a karaoke thing.
Yeah, can you use your mic? Sure. Can you put reverb in his mic? This is a big deal here. Well, this is a big budget show. We do things like this. Eddie.
Sure. Yeah.
You're doing great. Sorry that I have that disease that makes me sound like I'm yelling, but I really appreciate you on the show.
It's not that Who's funny. Doing the first?
Lynn.
Okay, and then I'll come
and then
in.
Then you'll come in.
All right.
Yeah, just have fun.
All right.
Play it nice and loud.
At first I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong.
What?
And I learned how to get along and sew your back. Yes, from outer space. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face.
I should have changed that stupid lock.
I should have changed, made you leave your keys.
If I'd known for just 1 second,
you'd be back to bother me. Oh, no, now go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now. You're not welcome anymore.
Warren, you the one who tried to hurt me with goodbye. Did you think I'd crumble?
Yeah.
Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, no, not I will
survive. Oh, as long as I know how to live, I know I'll be alive.
And I've got all my life to live, and I've got all my love to give, and I'll survive.
Yes, you will.
I will survive. Hey, 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 hey.
Oh, my God. That
felt really, really good.
That was amazing.
Thank you, Lynn.
Let me tell you something. You know what I thought? I thought you were going to do it different. And then when
what
you started,
how did you?
I thought I just pictured you were going to talk it.
But no,
then when
I
you started
no,
to sing, I loved it.
Yeah,
you
I tried,
did it. You committed, Eddie. These other pussies, they're afraid to come on.
Yeah, no. I always sing in the shower, man.
It took all that strength I had not to fall apart. Kept you my heart
and the pieces of my broken heart. And I spent so many nights feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry.
But what now?
I hold my head up high and you see me.
Yes, somebody new. I'm not that tender little person still in love with you.
And so you felt like dropping in and just expecting to be free. But now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me.
Oh!
Walk out the door. Just turn around now. Cause you're not welcome anymore.
Weren't you the one
trying to break me with mine? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? No, 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 no. I will survive.
Yes, you will. I've got all my love to live. I've got all my love to give.
And I'll survive.
Just turn around now, cause you're not welcome anymore.
Weren't you the one who tried to break me with goodbye?
Did you think I'd crumble?
No.
Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, no! I will survive! Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll be alive. I've got all my life to live. I've got all my love to give. I will survive.
What?
I will survive.
Hey.
I bought a dog. I bought a dog. And it's helping me through this breakup with you. I bought a dog. That dog gives me more love than you could ever do. I bought a dog.
And a jar of peanut butter.
And some peanut butter. I'm overeating since you've gone. I'm overeating and walking this dog.
and I'm surfing the net, and I'm jerking in off in weird things because you left. What I'm saying is I'll survive.
Thank you.
Yeah, bump it up, Eddie. Cool. Let's make it sound like we're a real group of people here. Put your bottle down, Watt, and applaud like a gentleman.
Toward the end, I was losing it, though. It was long.
That was pure joy.
Was it really?
Yes.
Really? I tried to throw myself into it.
You did. That's what's great. That's what I love about it.
It was pretty fun. It was pretty fun.
Did anyone feel like... Let me ask you this seriously.
I hope...
Did you think that was a toupee? No. Did you want to join in? Did you want to join in, everybody?
Because
that's a very catchy tune. It was an anthem for a generation.
It really was. I don't know.
What year really did that was. Song come out?
70s? Somewhere in the 70s, right?
Mm-hmm. I don't remember.
Mm-hmm. When was it? 77, 78. We put a man on the moon, I think, that year.
Yeah.
We put a man on the moon, and we've developed a cheese that would not clog, you know.
Yeah. And they cured polio that year.
That is, polio was eradicated.
In 78.
In 78.
Anyway. What's going on? It's all right. Eddie's talking. I'm over here trying to figure out my iPad.
Sorry, try it now.
Oh, there we go. Too loud.
What program is that, by the way?
I just break up songs so when I'm sitting home by myself, I can entertain myself. Like I sit around the house, I go, look at me, I'm sitting home by myself. What am I going to do? Ah, fuck it. All right, that's all. I sit around.
But that would lead to manic depression because it's like, what am I going to do? Bop, bop. And then you're back to your own, you know. That would fuck your brain up.
I'm home by myself.
I think I'll read Nietzsche. Nietzsche. There is no God. Absolutely no God.
Every man for himself.
There's no God. I'm alone in the universe.
Hey, want to do... Oh, I think we got to go in for the close. Jeez, fun stuff, Eddie. You're a ball of energy.
Eddie Pepitone.
We're going in for the close. Such a wonderful way to end today.
What's your housekeeper idea?
Thank you,
Daniel.
Thank you. I thanked him enough. I think. I mean, it seems like you're trying.
Never
to,
enough.
What is it, you two? It seems like you're fighting over my affection. Meanwhile, it wasn't. It was the other way around. Right, so listen. So it would have to be like I don't know why they couldn't just do this, a group of housekeepers in a neighborhood. But so look at it this way, and you'll know what I mean. So it would be great if you know how these planned communities. If within
what communities?
Planned communities, you know, like there's stores inside. There's a lot of stuff. Well, in that planned community, I'm actually being serious, but I'll make it quick. There's that you have.
House, I thought every community was planned. No, like they just throw the fucking store wherever. I don't give a shit. This is not a planned community.
Maybe this idea isn't worth telling.
Please tell it.
All right. Well, if I do declare. So there's a homeowners association or whatever it is. There's a thing in the neighborhood. And one of the services they offer is, okay, so everybody has – a lot of people can afford a housekeeper. It's not that big of a deal. But I wish I could have someone in an hour a day. But the only problem is you can't have a housekeeper come over for an hour. And what are they going to do? Then drive to another job? You can't make money that way. But if they were doing that in a neighborhood, so you can get like once a week you get full housekeeping day. But then if you want, it's $40 a day just to have them come in for an hour. In an hour, they could fold two loads of laundry, empty a dishwasher. Right. When you come in and aggressively, not like a maniac work, you can get a lot done in an hour. I would pay $40 a day for that, or 30, 40. Yeah.
Right.
So that's what I would do. This is so boring. But
is
it's
that
my
just
idea.
The idea?
That's just the idea. Daniel, you asked.
You wouldn't pay $40 a day.
Sure I would.
You think so?
I would have less to have
Do you
that.
Realize that's $1,200 a month?
Oh, forget it. It's a shitty idea.
Okay.
Jesus Christ, you ruined my whole idea. No, nothing could save that hunk of shit idea, not even that fun song. Well, I guess a little. Oh, that's right. Hey, look at me with my stupid ideas.
You could have, for the same price as a mortgage and a car payment, you could pay someone to fold your laundry for an hour a day.
That's true, too. All right, listen. Play the kid.
Boy, that was shot down like sorry, fucking guys. Kennedy in the Dallas thing.
And I don't think that's a toupee. I was just kidding you.
Put it back on.
Here, seriously, let me do this with a straight face. What if in a movie I had to do, they were the direction that I got to, could I do it with a straight face?
Yes.
And by the way, we tried this once before on a short film we worked on, and Eddie kept changing his line. And I remember going where I can't fucking laugh at him. Like, I was able to do it because it was an independent film. But
was
I thought
to
myself,
Save the Maverick?
Yeah. I thought to myself, what if it was a high budget movie? And I knew I could get a few turns here and get some laughs out of it. But what if it was a movie? So that's what I thought going into it one more time. They go, action. And then he would do his line a little different. I would go, motherfucker, I can't do it. So I would go, just do it again. And then I thought to myself, I just got yelled at, the whole thing, right? And I would start it with Eddie. And here's what it turned into. This was the best that I got. Okay. But this isn't suffice.
Mm-hmm.
So they can't use it. It was
when
hard.
Is that coming out? That thing. We did that 10 years ago. At this
was
point.
It 10 years ago? You know what we did? We sat around in the house. Eddie would
unbelievable.
Should we talk?
Okay, can I give you the direction for this?
Yeah.
This is basically, you know, you've been friends for like 20 years, mm-hmm. and finally for whatever reason you called him on it and you rip it and you feel fucking terrible about it. And you have to say, and he's so fucking delusional, he'll take it from you.
That's right.
Okay, listen to this. Thank you. Thank you.
He's
great
so
direction. Thank you. He's
so, but you just have to sell it to him well enough.
Sure.
So what do you want to say? What are you talking about?
Oh, I'm going to give you your toupee back.
No, don't say that to him in the scene.
No, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to say,
it's
I get
not
it.
A toupee,
Eddie.
Asshole.
Eddie.
Yeah.
What?
Do we get a little music in the background, like that old timing?
Yeah, put it like this is like this is the end of Act 3. This is the like you know the reconnection of the two friends.
A little lower. A lot lower, actually. Real soft. A little lower. Lower. Here, let me do it.
You are the manager who tried to revive his career and make him... You try to make him be more real, and you ripped that thing off his head, and you pushed him for a movie.
Okay.
And then he didn't get the movie at the end, and now you realize he's going to die soon.
Hey, how can it be a minute? How can it be a minute with that minute direction?
Let's see how good you are.
You're eating into my bit with your direction.
Let's do it.
Okay, let's go. Eddie. You're a good friend. I was being a dick. I know it's your hair. I don't know why I was just being... Just wanted to hurt you because I guess... I don't know. Sometimes I'm jealous of your success. I know it's your hair. I was being an asshole.
Thank you.
Everybody.
Because it is my hair.
You have to give him the hair.
I swear, I know, I tried. Fuck you. You try to sit across
no,
from that.
No, you have to go. I know it's
I'm
your hair.
I'm going to. And I'm going
okay,
to.
Okay, okay. Right,
I couldn't
right.
stop laughing at that.
Let's try
he
it.
Said he said
take two.
No, hold
take
on. Two. I
Cut.
No, shut up.
I'm directing.
Shut up,
you
Daniel.
Don't tell the director
Daniel,
to shut up.
Daniel, you shut the I do. In this movie, I'm just as
yeah,
big
now,
as
here's,
you.
Here's
no,
again,
please
right?
let me like, get this out. That was so funny that I cracked up laughing, and you went, you're not. Yeah, you. That was very, he, you know, oh, here's the line. He said, I know it is my hair. He's a lying sack of shit. He goes, I know it is. Of course that made me bust a guy. This can't be a minute. I'm doing silly dance. I can't let everyone out of here without silly dance, so I hope we're going to be able to do it. Okay, so let me do it again. Here we go. Eddie. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. I was being a jerk. Sometimes
well,
I get jealous
thank,
of you.
Thank you.
I know that it's your hair. I was being an asshole.
Well,
I was just being an asshole.
Thank you for admitting that it is my hair because it is. And thank you.
And I just want to.
Why you?
No, I'm getting upset. I'm getting upset. I want to give you your hair back.
That means a lot to me.
I should have never taken it from you. It's obvious that it's real. I'm just a dick. I'm jealous and sometimes I act out. I was an asshole. And I know it's your hair. It always has been. And why would it look so
do you,
nice?
Do you now see that it is my hair?
Yes. Yes, I do. I honestly do.
You see what I was saying? It's my hair.
The funniest thing ever to see this for me is just pure joy.
It's my hair, man!
It's also incredibly sad. That's how good it is.
No, it's nice that you gave me.
We just tell them now we're done. We know what going down the path, truth path.
Yeah, no, it looks great.
I was being a dick. I don't know why I was being a dick. Obviously, that's your hair. Everybody knows it's your hair. Everyone was like,
"Thank you." They all thought it was, and
they were vindicated.
And they were vindicated.
In the end.
Oh God! Oh.
No, I mean, I just want to say this as a friend.
Oh, don't you dare give me advice.
No,
just be happy.
I just want to say this.
Yes, what? What do you want to say?
That.
Because don't push it, basically. No, no, that's your hair and get it.
No, I just want to say it was big of you to admit it, that it was my hair. You're a bigger man than I thought you were.
Thank you.
Before you thought it wasn't. And then the credits roll like this. The credits.
Yeah.
The credits, like, just down here are the credits.
Oh.
Play the clown song.
I'm going to have podcast hangover tomorrow. I'll tell you why. When I go into convulsions, I'm aware sometimes, like, I look like an hysterical person at a movie theater. You know, that's laughing hysterically, like a deaf comedy jam when the people in the audience are like, that's how I feel. And then that gets me to, oh, my God. And then when I wake up, I think... myself hitting the table looking like
should
a maniac.
Should we do that silly?
I think we should.
I think we should.
Can we? Because, okay, good, good, good. That's how I wanted to end it. Really good. So
I forgot how it goes. But.
Well, you're at a party and you want everyone to silly dance and you see some people. You know,
that aren't
people,
authentic.
Yeah, they think they're trying to look dance cool. Silly dance, okay. You do this. You can walk around holding your cake. You don't need people in there trying to dance because it makes everybody else. And you're so basically you love silly dancing, but you're also... You're a maniac about it.
Okay.
You stop the
party.
Let's
do it. I remember.
Even if it wasn't perfect, when you're yelling at everybody at the party, it's not good. 3 minutes?
All right. So here we go. So, hey, what about a silly dance, everybody? Do people like the silly dance?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Everybody
like
the silly dance?
Yeah.
Let's go. I love silly dancing.
Okay. Sure.
Right, cool.
So
yeah, definitely. Can you guys play something? Here we go. Let's see.
Papa loves mambo. Mama loves mambo. Rockin' and sway with it. It's a game with it. Shout no lay with it.
Hey!
Papa loves mambo.
What the fuck? What the fuck was... Wait a minute. Name Chris?
Yeah.
What the fuck is this bullshit? That's not a silly dance.
That's
not a silly dance! A silly dance is like... You know, it's something like that. It's the... What the fuck?
Eddie, are we gonna silly dance? Don't ruin the silly dance, Eddie. Come on, these are guys that work with me all the time.
No, I'm sorry, I attacked you, but if you're not gonna silly dance. Fucking silly dance!
Just give him another shot. It's okay.
Just give him another shot.
He's not
good
the only one, but go ahead.
What did I do?
Let's silly dance.
All right, let's do it. Let's go, guys. Here we go. Anybody wants a silly dance.
Why? Because I had a little criticism? Let's do it.
Maybe he's right.
No, all right, let's try.
Okay, play it. Let's just have some fun.
Mama loves mambo.
Stop it!
Mama loves mambo.
Stop it! Mama
Sit down.
Let him fuck it down.
Scream.
Hold on. Hold on, Eddie. Hold on, Lynn. Hold on.
Dance.
Yeah. Let me show you fucking idiots what silly dancing is.
By the way, I would never come to a silly dance party at your house again.
No, this is the worst thing. No. I'm the bad guy.
Yes, yes.
I'm the bad guy.
Yes, you're
because I know what a silly dance should look like.
You're out of your
fucking
mind.
It should look like this.
Difference.
Do you see the fucking difference?
Papa loves mambo. No, play it, play it.
Mama loves mambo. Look at him sway with it, getting so gay with it, shout no lay with it.
That's
wow.
A silly
dick. Papa loves mambo.
Papa loves mambo.
Here's
another
Mama
silly dick.
Mambo.
Mama loves mambo.
Papa loves
sperm. Sperm is coming out.
Sway with it, with it.
I want this on the record.
Shut it off. You know what? You know
I
what?
I want this on the record.
You know what, Eddie? I'm not
you
even going to...
don't know what silly dancing is, and you take the silliness out of it.
I'm going to tell you. Can I say...
Not me.
Eddie, I'll tell you
yes,
what.
Yes, I'm a little critical.
A little?
Yes, I'm a little critical.
Eddie, that
because
was...
Because I have high standards when it comes to silly dancing. Oh, so let's let silly dancing go the way of this country, down the shitter. No, I say keep silly dancing up here, not down.
I think you're overreacting a little.
Well, I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry. It's you know, you say to me, and I don't like when you do this.
What did I do wrong?
Well, you say to me, Eddie, let's do silly dancing, and it's something I've spent a greater part of 30 well, years.
So we can't ever silly dance in front of you then, because it seems like you can.
Well,
you,
not
can
if you're going to take it haphazardly. People don't. No. People don't put a lot into their silly dancing. They take it like, oh, let's all be silly.
Eddie,
go fuck yourselves.
I guess that's what we'll end the show that way.
Oh, is it a bad note? Should we dance? Is it a bad note? Oh,
you know what? I think we should ignore him.
Don't call it silly dancing.
Okay, I guess what we're going to do. Can we have a serious, can we have a dance not right contest? We're all going to try to dance bad.
That I could deal with.
Okay, that's what we're going to try to do. Here's what I want everyone to do.
But don't call it silly dancing.
No, it's not
silly. I've spent a better part of my fucking life perfecting it.
This is called dancing
watching
bad.
You. Okay.
Do you want to dance? Can we dance bad?
Yes.
Let's have a dance bad fun dance fun contest.
Not this is silly.
Not no.
Wait,
no, hey, this is not.
Should we say goodbye and then?
Yeah,
dance?
Goodbye, everybody. This was a lot of fun. thank you, Joey. Where's Joey?
Joey's there.
Joey's there, ladies and gentlemen. He does the, he travels with me on the road and he does this.
He does it
ladies
live.
Ladies and gentlemen.
He pays him $40 a day. He folds his laundry and just does that beat.
Thank you, everybody. Eddie Pepitone. Woo! Dance.
Thank you, everybody.
Well, that was quite a situation there.
The fuck are you doing? That's bullshit.
You're sit dancing.
Sit dancing? That's fucking
Mama
stupid. Look at this shit.
Look at him sway with it, getting so gay with it.
What the fuck is this?
Papa loves
oh, no.
Mambo.
Oh, no. Shit.
Mama loves
Mambo. Shit.
Mama loves Mambo. Papa's just great with it. Swings like
yo.
A gate with it. He goes and quaint with it. Now he goes to... She goes...
Next time you're here with headphones in your ear, there's a lot of show left, so stay right here.
Hey everybody, this is Todd Glass. Why don't you like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel? This is what I'm told to do. People tell me, Todd, you gotta tell, throw people to your website. So, really doing this against my will.
Todd Glass, we've got Todd Glass. We've got High on the Mic with Reverb Glass. So anytime you're getting low, instead of letting go, sit and let the time pass. Hey, here comes another Todd Glass show. Hey, here comes